Bishop Kahuma advised the Christians during his pastoral visit to St. Luke Church of Uganda, Kagadi Archdiaconry in Kagadi District. He highlighted the policy by the Anglican province for every church to have a coffee plantation project alongside other income-generating projects at household levels.
The strength of the Christian families is the strength of the church, and the weaknesses of the Christian families is the weakness of the church. So we want to urge our Christians, and especially this year when we have declared a policy for all churches and all our Christians to plant coffee. We have made it a project. It was passed last week in the Dutchson Council, and we are going to go around. We're going to ask UCDA to help us. We want at every church to have a coffee plantation. It can be small, ranging from the size of the land they have, and then the other crops.
Bishop Kahuma also confirmed over 200 children in the Anglican Church and laid a foundation stone for the construction of the church house.
We have confirmed over 200 candidates in the Christian faith. Confirming 200 candidates in the Christian faith is a big step forward in the building of the Church of God, because many of these are younger people who are growing, and since many of us are becoming of age, then we expect we'll have a church and leadership that will come behind us.
He has also asked Christians to live morally faithful lives and shun paganism, theft, vandalism, corruption and envy,
and to ensure that the faith they have is not adulterated, especially in the age of today where we have many false teachings, many heretics and many other sorts of things. So if you are a Christian, if you are not careful, if you are not holding firm your faith, you can easily lose it. And when you lose it, you have lost your ticket to heaven. You have lost your passport to heaven.
Reverend Patrick Musinguzi, the vicar at St. Luke Church of Uganda Archdiaconry, has congratulated the church on a number of successful projects like the purchase of church land, owning land titles, holy matrimony, ordination, confirmation and baptism of children. However, he expressed concern over external interference from the public during church programs.
Really having happened, especially during my time really of the leadership of operation as a vicar here. And again, I want to thank God for many things that have taken place, that we have put in place. Right now, there is a house that we have named a house for a purpose. That for us, we are focusing in the future. We are focusing on the future. That in the future, as this church now grows, we expect this church to make a demand, to formulate a demand, that when you are not technical at headquarters or state, can't you really move to another step in future, you know, whether it will be around or where this church will be declared a diocese.
The children and their parents thanked Bishop Kahuma for the confirmation service, promising to abide by confirmation vows and walking in the light of Jesus Christ through good deeds to their parents, teachers and the general public.
Today I've been confirmed by the right Bishop Samuel Kahuma of Wall, and the message has delivered to us is that we should be disciplined, self-contained and work hard.
Mama just told us that we need to respect our elders.
Yes.
To be faithful and to be going at the church every day, and we respect our elders.
Okay.
Compiled by Andrew Musinguzi for the news.